go to the Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَهُوَ لَهَا. And when all of humanity, from the beginning of Adam to the end of life, go to recognize Allah, come in search of one to ask for them, they come to none but Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And on that day, the Prophet will receive this invitation from them and he will say, أَنَا لَهَا, أَنَا لَهَا. I have been destined for this moment. Why does he say this sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Because every Prophet and every Messenger, as the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us in Sahih al-Bukhari, مَا مِن نَبِيٍّ, not a single Prophet, not a single Messenger, إِلَّا وَلَهُ دَعْوَةٌ مُسْتَجَابَةٌ, except Allah promised them a dua, if they made it, it's answered. And every Prophet of Allah, every Messenger of Allah, asked Allah for what they wanted, except your Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They said to him, Ya Rasulullah, wa ma da'watuk? What is the dua that you will make? And he said, اختبأتُ دعوتي شفاعةً لأمتي. I've kept my dua so that I can ask Allah protection for my ummah on the Day of Judgment, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. خَيْرُ الْخَلْقِ رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, mercy, not just to our nation, not just رَحْمَةً لِأُمَّتِهِ, but رَحْمَةً to the nations who came before him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all of those who pass upon his path, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. And therefore you find the mention of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is marvelous. And you can sit hours without feeling tired. And what you will know is, as much as you remember him, you know there is more to remember. And as much as you describe him, you feel there is deficiency in your description. And as much as you think of his character, you understand the deficiencies in your own. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, although we speak to him of him in these large attributes and his nearness to Allah and his mastership of humanity as the leader of humanity, we come to establish أَنَّهُ رَجُلٌ, that he was a man. كَانَ يَمْشِي بَيْنَ النَّاسِ, he would walk amongst people. And the mushrikeen, they would see Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah quotes their words in the Qur'an. وَقَالَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مَا لِهَذَا الرَّسُولِ, what is this messenger? يَمْشِي بَيْنَ النَّاسِ يَأْكُلُ الطَّعَامَ وَيَمْشِي فِي الْأَسْوَاقِ, he eats food like us, he walks in the market, has to buy and sell and trade, sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. If you were to see the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam today, you would not recognize him by fancy clothes. He didn't have particular guards or particular people to surround him and protect him, even from those who wished his death. Never do you find that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, even in the most difficult of times, that he asked people to surround him. Rather, he would say to them, walk in front of me, don't be fearful. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has promised my protection. He had tawakkul upon Allah. He had a reliance upon Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He would sleep after a battle under a tree. And no guard and no protection and no bodyguard and no SAS and no FBI. And the Prophet sleeping under this tree. And one of the mushrikeen comes and takes the Prophet's sword, his own sword sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which he had hung on a branch. وَأَخَذَ سَيْفَ النَّبِيَّ sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he wakes up Rasulullah. He said, who can save you now, Ya Muhammad? And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, Allah. And the man trips and the sword falls from his hand. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam picks up the sword and gives it back to him. And says, who can save you from me? And the man says, أَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهُ وَسَلَّمُ. This is our Nabi, a man of medium height. He wasn't tall, wasn't short. He was a person who, when they described him, that they would say he was athletic, maftool. His shoulders was always back, he never hunched over. When he walked, people had to run to catch him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He knew where he was going and what he wanted in life. If he sat, he was quiet. The majority of people would say, the thing we know most about him was his ability to remain silent and listen to us. كَانَ الْيَتَامَ يَأْخُذُونَهُ بِالْأَيَادِ, the orphans, the young, the people who were on the fringe of society, would be able to hold his hand for Ali Sallam after his prayer and bring them away and say, come with me, Ya Rasulullah. I want you to be with me for a few moments. His access was not limited just to the powerful and the mighty, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was a person who, when difficulty struck, he was a part of the difficulty of his ummah and not protected from it. He never sat in a tent far away while others starved. Food was not brought to him when others needed. In fact, in the authentic hadith in Sahih al-Bukhari, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the middle of the night, because of his hunger, he couldn't sleep. فَخَرَجَ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ فَرَأَ أَبَا بَكْرَ وَعُمَرَ. And he sees Abu Bakr and Umar. They're hungry as well. مَا أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنَ الْبَيْتِ. Why are you here? They said, وَاللَّهِ مَا أَخْرَجَنَا إِلَّا الْجُوعِ. Wallahi, by Allah, O Messenger of Allah, nothing brought us out of our home except hunger. And he says to them, same with me. Let's go to one of the men of the Ansar. And they come to this man of the Ansar, and the Prophet ﷺ comes to the home, and the man was out trying to find some food. And when he's coming home, he sees Muhammad ﷺ from a distance. He says, the barakah has arrived to me. I have to do something. And the only sheep he had, he took it, slaughtered it, prepared it for food. And the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ and his companions, he says to them, ask the people of Kufa. Ask everyone. We're not just going to eat here by ourselves. وَامْتَلَأَ الْبَيْتِ. And the house was filled, and the street was filled, and thousands of people arrived, all looking for food. And it's recorded on that moment that Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiallahu anhu, he says, كُنَّا نَسْمَعُ التَّسْبِيحِ. In the food that we ate, we could hear the food making tasbih of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is your Nabi Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. In the most difficult of times, he linked people to Allah. And the difficulties that he experienced in life, if you were to face one of the hundreds, you would collapse. The Prophet ﷺ buried his daughter, buried his son, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, buried his wife, Khadija radiallahu anha, buried his grandfather, his father, his mother, his uncle, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Kana yateem. أَلَمْ يَجِدْكَ يَتِيمًا فَآوَى. Did we not find you, O Muhammad, orphaned, and Allah protected you? The Prophet ﷺ would experience the harm of those who were near to him. His own uncles, people who wished to, who knew the truth. Abu Jahl, who would come to the Prophet ﷺ in his drunkenness and speak to him with sinful words. When he would wake up from his drunk, he used to sit under the window of the Prophet ﷺ in the middle of the night. يَسْتَمِعُ إِلَى الْقُرْآنِ. He used to know that the Qur'an is truth. And Allah records the words of Abu Jahl that he said in secret. Abu Jahl said to the one of the people of Quraysh, وَاللَّهِ إِنِّي أَعْلَمُ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ. By Allah, I know it is the truth, but I cannot accept it. And I would rather rocks and stones from heaven rain down and kill me than to accept him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And تُمْتِرْ عَلَيْنَا مِنَ السَّمَاءِ حِجَارَةً. That I would rather, as is in Surah Al-Anfal, rocks fall from the heaven to kill me than to accept him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah would say, they know you as they know their own children. يَعْرِفُونَهُ كَمَا يَعْرِفُونَ أَبْنَاءَهُمْ صلى الله عليه وسلم. But that level of arrogance and audacity is what keeps people away from understanding the truth of al-hidayah that comes through al-irshad of discovery of the word of Allah and the sunnah of the Messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. In khutbah al-jum'ah, inshaAllah, we will speak about how to get closer to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah al-azim li wa lakum bi tahmeen. Assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.
Allahu akbar.
أكبر.
الله أكبر الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله
صلى الله.
أشهد أن أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له